Today you're going to learn the easy step-by-step process to make any of your photos look soft and dreamy in Photoshop. So let's get started. Hello friend, my name is Brendan from bewillcreative.com, and this is the photo that we'll be working with today. And admittedly, it already is quite soft looking because of the wide open aperture that I used to take this photo. However, with the effects that we're about to apply, it's going to take it even further. Now the first step in the process is we need to duplicate our image layer so that we do all of our edits non-destructively. To do that, select your image layer and press Command or Control J to create a copy. Now, since the first few adjustments are going to be filters, we're going to right click and go to Convert to Smart Object. That way we can go back and edit our filters later on. As you can see, my layer is now converted to a smart object, so now we can go and do our first adjustment, which is in Camera Raw. To access Camera Raw, just go up to Filter and down here to Camera Raw Filter. And now in Camera Raw, we're gonna use a radial gradient to make everything outside of our subject look a little bit softer. To begin, we'll click on the masking icon and then go to the radial gradient. Now we'll click and drag out around the subject, and then we'll move our gradient over so that the outside edges of the gradient extend past our subject. That way our subject will be left untouched by all the adjustments we're about to create. Now with radial gradients, you obviously have the feather slider to change how blended the effect looks, but since we want this effect to look very smooth and subtle in the background, we're gonna bring up that feather a fair bit here, like so, so we have a nice soft edge. Now currently our adjustment is affecting our subject. We want to affect the background instead. So to do that, we'll click on our radial gradient and then go to invert. Now everything except for our subject is going to be edited with the adjustments that we make. Scrolling down here to the effects panel, we're going to drag that down like so, and then go to the texture slider and drag that down a bit as well. What that does is just softens out the background with minimal effort. With that all good to go, we're finished in Camera Raw, so we'll click OK. Now, as you can see, we have that Camera Raw filter applied as a smart filter below our image, and that way we can double click on that at any point in the project and go back and make any changes if needed. Now, the second adjustment to add to this effect is a blur filter. So once again, with our image layer selected, we'll go up to Filter, Blur Gallery, and then Iris Blur. Now this will leave you with a radial looking filter once again, but this time anything outside of this radial filter is going to have a blur applied to it. So to highlight this over in my Iris Blur, I'll increase the amount of pixels here to a really high amount. And you can see how the background or everything outside of this line becomes very blurred, and then it tapers off to the point that there's no more blur in the center of our radial filter here. You can adjust the feather of this just by moving these circles on the inside of the filter. So I'll position this somewhere around here, make sure that I have a nice subtle feather coming from the background, but I don't want this blur to be so intense, so I'm gonna bring that down to zero and work my way up just a little bit to something like that. Looks good for me. Once you're happy with your adjustments, just go and click OK. Now that additional blur will be added as a second smart filter below your smart object, you can once again double click on this word blur gallery to go back and edit that later on if needed. Now so far, turning that on and off, you can see the huge difference that we've made to soften out the image. But we have a couple more effects that will make this even better, and the first is adding some enhanced lighting effects. To do this, I'll click on my curves adjustment layer, and then I'll just drag up the midtones like so, just to boost the brightness. Now with that layer mask selected, I'll press Command or Control I to invert that mask, and now everything from this adjustment is not affecting my image. That means we can add this light effect in one specific part of the photo, preferably from a light source. To reveal that light source, I'll grab my gradient tool, click on my gradient editor, and then make sure I have the foreground to transparent gradient enabled. Click OK. Now with my foreground color set to white and that layer mask selected, I'll choose a radial gradient and then click and drag out like so to add that brightening effect just in this area. Now once you've applied your gradient to the mask, you can double click on the curves adjustment and do further changes to this as needed. In this case, I'll add a little bit of contrast back there by bringing down the shadows just to enhance that effect a bit more. Turning that on and off, you can just see how that adds a little bit of life to the light source, aka the sun in my photo. Now we're going to boost the overall color in the photo, and you can either do that with a vibrance adjustment layer, or you can just go to the hue saturation adjustment layer and then choose the specific colors that you would like to boost the saturation of. This is going to change depending on your particular photo, so do with this as you wish. In this case, I'm just boosting the reds and the yellows just slightly for this photo. Now the final effect that we'll use to tie everything together is called the Orton effect. And the Orton effect allows you to apply specific glows to your photo, and it works really well in these types of images as well as in landscape photos. To create the Orton effect, we need to shift click all of our top layers here, excluding our locked background layer, and we'll press Command or Control J and then Command or Control E. So that will duplicate and merge all of our layers. Now with that merge layer selected, I'll double click on this and call this to Orton. Now we need to add a Gaussian blur to this layer by going to filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. I'll set a blur radius to a point where I still see some details in my photo, but it's mostly blurred out, like so, and click OK. Now I'll create a curves adjustment layer, add a clipping mask, and then increase the highlights and bring down the shadows like this. That way, this adjustment only affects our Orton layer. Now clicking on our Orton layer, we'll set the layer blending mode from normal to screen, and now we have that really glowy effect. But in most cases, this will look a little bit intense, so I'll go to the opacity and just bring this down a touch like so. Now with the general intensity of the effect looking good, you probably don't want it affecting your subject or certain details in the photo because it kind of washes it out as you can see here. So I'll add a layer mask to that Orton layer, press Command or Control I to invert that mask, and now that Orton layer is completely invisible. Now I can grab my brush tool, set my foreground color to white with the 100% opacity brush and 100% flow. I can go and paint in selective areas that I want this effect to apply. Now, if it's still looking too intense, you can of course bring down the opacity of that layer and then continue to paint as you wish in the areas that you want to apply that selective glow to. Once you're done with that, turning that on and off, you can see how it just adds an extra little something to the photo. And again, this works really well, even as a standalone option for adding glow effects to your photos. Now, with all those adjustments complete, we have completed our soft glowy effect. Looking at our before and after, you can see the massive difference that that does to enhance the light in our photo, make things look a little bit more dreamy, and it was all pretty straightforward with a few filters and adjustment layers to help with the process. Now, if you like dreamy photos, the Orton effect is a super valuable thing to try more often in your edits. And if you want to make the process a little bit faster, I have a Photoshop action over on my website for the Orton effect. You can check that out down in the description below. Anyways, my name is Brendan from bewillcreative.com. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If you did, make sure to hit that like button down below, and I'll catch you back here next time. See ya then.